Hi, I'm Chris from Premier Guitar. We're at the Montreal Guitar Show, and we're talking with Scott Walker of Walker Guitars. Hi, Scott.
Hey, Chris.
So I understand this is the Santa Cruz guitar, and there's sort of a history, a story behind the name here. Can you tell us about it?
Sure. Well, I live in Santa Cruz, California, and basically I worked at Santa Cruz Guitar Company for years, and they've inspired me to create my own electric guitars, and this one's kind of in tribute to Santa Cruz and guitars. It's swamp ash body, and basically it's a 24 fret, 25 inch scale length guitar. This one has the Lawler single coils in it, and it's got a tobacco sunburst, as you can see, rosewood fingerboard. I do a lot of the carvings and try to restrain myself sometimes, but this is what comes out. All of this is proprietary to me and my company.
This is a beautiful piece of rosewood you've got on the fretboard here.
Yeah, we are lucky in Santa Cruz to get some of the nice rosewoods there. And it's got a mahogany neck. You can see the swamp ash one-piece body. And this model does come in, you know, it's a custom guitar. You can get it in any kind of wood combination you want. I just thought it would be fun for the show to do a one-piece swamp ash with the single coils.
Sure is pretty. What's the voice of the guitar really aiming for?
It's an open, airy guitar. It's very dynamic. It's got a lot of versatility in response to, you know, the player's touch. It's fairly light, you know, signature kind of swamp ash weight, and the Lawler single coils are just great, very articulate, dynamic pickups. So all around, it's good for clean tones up to more crunchier stuff. So it kind of does it all.
So you have a very special thing going on here with the electronics in these guitars.
Yeah. So this is the fun part. It can be used like a conventional, just mono, regular guitar, or you can get as fancy as you want with the two jacks, basically a mono jack and a stereo jack. And the stereo jack is what it is. It's not a stereo guitar, but the guitar has a built-in effects loop. So the signal goes from the pickups down one side of the stereo jack to your effects, back from the effects back up the other side of the stereo cable to the volume knob, and then out through the mono jack to your amplifier. So it's what happens is your effects are always reading 100% output from your pickups, no matter where your volume is at. And there's also a bypass switch, so you can go directly to your amp or kick on the loop. So you can have, you know, all of your effects on, but go right to the amp or kick the loop on. There's also a built-in preamp, and this is the gain knob, 0 to 6 dB gain. So you can actually drive your effects a little bit harder while still having an overall master volume. This way, your effects don't change the way that they are hearing the signal. There's also the preamp bypass, so you can play completely passive and get that traditional sound, or kick in the preamp, which gives it the clarity, changes the signal to low impedance, so you get no tone loss through your cables.
It's a very cool idea.
It's a lot of fun. There's a lot of options and possibilities with it, so it's pretty fun. And then the tone knob, so it's basically it.
This is the Phoenix model.
Yep, the Phoenix model. It's basically brand new. I think this is the third one I've built. It's based off of a fairly traditional Fender Jazzmaster style design, but I've collaborated with a few different people on this. This is a collaboration between Jason Lawler on these blade style Jazzmaster pickups, Steve Kimmock, who came up with the electronics package, and John Cutler, who designed the preamp. And it's a copper pick guard that actually shields the electronics that I've done some patina over top and then engraved some of the design. The electronics on this guitar got one jack, but is stereo. And it could also be mono. You can play it just mono, normal, like a regular guitar, or with a stereo Y cable. You can send each pickup to a different amp. So you got amp A and amp B. And with the flip of the switch, you can switch which pickup goes to which amp. With the stereo mono switch, you can send both pickups in mono to one amp or send both pickups to the other amp. We also have a two-channel preamp that you can either bypass, play it completely passive or active. Volume, volume, tone, tone, and these are double pots that are both have two section pots, one for the passive section, one for the active section. Phase off, phase for the pickups. So what happens is you have ultimate control over which phase the pickup is with your amplifier. When the pickup is in phase with your amp, your speaker fires forward. When it's out of phase with your amp, your speaker fires backwards. Here, when you have an effect, some effects will reverse the phase of your pickup, so you have ultimate control of what the phasing is when it reaches your amp. It's mahogany, curly mahogany.
It's a really nice curl, too. I mean, you can see the depth of the detail in it.
Yep, we're really lucky to have kind of a limited supply of this curly mahogany from Belize.
And the neck is the same mahogany, yep. But not finished.
Right, curly mahogany, oiled neck. It's got a volute on the Fender-style headstock, which was pretty fun to do. Again, a rosewood fingerboard, and it's also got the carbon rods reinforcing that.
Cool. We were holding this guitar yesterday. It's kind of a heavy guitar. It's a little on the heavy side, about 9 pounds.
Yeah, it's about 9 pounds. The mahogany varies. This is part of the trunk of the tree, which is kind of a little more dense than some of it. So it varies. Yeah.
Very cool. So people that are interested in Walker Guitars can go online to
ScottWalkerGuitars.com.
Thanks very much, Scott. I appreciate
it. Thanks, Chris.
I'm Chris Burgess. You're watching PremierGuitar.com.